Hello everyone, this is Hoda Ganji. In this video, I'm going to talk about some tips and tricks for presentation drawings. I want to open a new file, metric architectural template. I want to change the units, type UN, and the length to meters, three decimal places. And I'll show you that even though your units are in meters, maybe, you can still show the dimensions in millimeters. So let's say maybe I have just a few walls here and a roof, but I'm just gonna continue with this. In my site plan, I wanna show the main entrances. Now, under annotate, you can of course go to detail line and create it here, but a better way is to create a detail item family so you can always use it in this project and in future projects. So see this component here. The difference between component under annotate and the component under architecture or structure menu is that this one is in 3D, the one under annotate is in 2D. Okay, so if I go to component load family, you need to go to detail items and anything which is here, they're only 2D, they're not 3D, and you can use it for your presentation drawings. Now, let's say maybe there is something that you want and it's not there, so let's create it. In order to create one of these families, which go under the 2D components, you can go to File, New, Family. I want to go with a metric detail item. That's the family. In my family, I want to create one triangle, so I can maybe go with 400 here, some values here, and I want it to be black. So under create, I want to go with field region. I want to pick these three lines and I can change this to solid field black. You can also create other ones if you go to edit types. Okay, and I want to save this family, so I want to save it. Where are the families in Revit? They are in your C drive, program data, Autodesk, RVT 2022, and libraries. For me, it's English, and here under detail items. So maybe instead of this location, I will go to my Autodesk folder and I want to create a folder here. So if I change my Revit version, this new family is not in that specific Revit version folder. I want to name it as special families or something. And I want to make one folder for detail items. So I won't accidentally open this as a 3D component later, because then you got again and get an error. And I want to name this as main entrance symbol. That should be good. Under options, I want to change this to only one backup. Okay, and save. Okay, now I want to load this into family. In your other projects, you can go to annotate component. And if you don't see it here, go to load family, go to the location that you saved your file. For me, I put it under special families here. Detail items, and I have it here. You can load it into project. I can just put the symbol here somewhere, right? And if you see that maybe this one is too small, you can get back to your family, adjust it and go back. Okay, so the second thing I wanted to talk about are the dimensions. If I type DI for now from here to here, because I set the units to meters, it's gonna also show that in meters. But even though your file might be in meters, you can go to edit type and you can go to primary units, and you see that it's reading the units that you assigned because there is a check mark here which says use project settings. So I want to work with meters, but I want the units to show in millimeters, no decimal places. So zero decimal places. So then you can change it to this. And now although I'm working in meters, the dimensions are gonna be in millimeters. Another thing I wanted to show you is maybe you wanna add a line to show fire rating or something, right? So I can go to annotate detail line, and you see there are already some lines here, right? But maybe I want to have my own type of line, my own line style. So I can go to manage. Under additional settings, we have line styles, and all the lines are here. So how about I create a new line? I want to name it as fire rating, for instance, 2 hour. Okay. And feel free to change the color. If you are going with colored plants, you can change the line weight. Maybe it's going to be thicker. Okay. It's not going to be solid in this case. I want to go with one of the dashed lines. Maybe dash dot dot or something. Apply and okay. And now if I draw a line here, I can actually go with my own fire rating 2R, right? If I change it to thick lines, type TL for thick line, thin line, which is also here, you see that actually it has a thickness. And if you want to change it, you can go back to line styles, go back here and change it. Feel free to change different lines for your drawings. You can also create a grade line for your elevations, and it's gonna be maybe a solid thick line, so you can change it to whatever number you want, right? So it's gonna be a very thick line. And next thing I wanted to show you is how to blacken the walls. So if I change this to shaded, it already blackens it, but maybe you want to go with something different, or maybe you want to stay in hidden line mode, but for some reason, and then you want the lines to be blackened. So you can go to VG, visibility graphics, type VG or double V, and we can go to walls. And now you see we have some settings in projection and surface and cut. In level one, in a plan view, the wall is cut. So I want the line or the pattern to be different. So I can go here and change this pattern, either foreground or background. I can change it to a solid fill maybe, and I can choose my own color here. Okay, okay, apply, okay. Now you see, even though this is not in shaded, it's in hidden line, I can have my own actually settings. And because also shaded view, sometimes it's actually limited. Maybe for some reason you want to go with a different color, with a different gray color or something. So all of that you can take care of by going to visibility graphics menu.